Hello students, welcome to part 4 of chapter 10, that is financial market in business studies. So in this session, we are going to learn about trading and settlement procedure. Now we have online trading, and trading in security is now carried out through online screen-based electronic trading system. So buying and selling of securities are effected through computer terminal. Now, shares can be held either in physical form or in electronic form. In physical form, a share certificate is issued and it is a proof of ownership of securities, whereas the electronic form is called the dematerialized form. When the securities are bought and sold, it must be settled within 2 days of the trade. At present, T+2 pattern is followed, which means the settlement is made within 2 days from the date of transaction. Now, this system of settlement is called rolling settlement. Now, when we talk about the steps in trading and settlement procedure, that is purchase and sale of security, the first step is selection of broker. Second step is you have to open a DMAT account with the depository participants. And thirdly, placing the order for purchase or sale of security with the broker. After that, there is execution of order through computer terminal. And fifthly, there is delivery of contract note to the investor, which contains the details regarding the name of security, number of security bought or sold, rate at which the deal was made, and the brokerage, etc. After this step, the next step comes is effecting changes in the DMAT account. And lastly, making or receiving the payment of money. So these are the simple steps in trading and settlement procedure. Now let's understand that what are the advantages of online trading. Online trading allows the participants to view the prices of all the securities on the real-time basis. So we can say that it has transparency, which is one of the advantages. Secondly, computer screen displays the capital market developments that influences the share prices. So you can get the information very efficiently. And it also reduces the time, cost, and the efforts. Now, online trading, it has a wide coverage. So we can say that it has a wide coverage because people from all over the world can participate in buying and selling of securities by sitting in front of computer. All the trading centers spread across the world is brought into a single online platform, which is another major advantage. So we can see the advantages of online trading. Now, what is dematerialization and depository services? A depository is an organization where the securities of shareholders are held in electronic form at the request of shareholders through the medium of depository participants. One of the example over here which is given is NSDL. In the depository system, securities are held in depository account, which is just like holding money in bank account. And it is an electronic record of share ownership. These depository system leads to the capital market towards scriptless trading through dematerialization of securities. And to trade in dematerialized form, a DMAT account has to be opened. And the organization that offers this facility is called depository participants. In India, two depositories are operating in the market, namely NSDL and CDSL. Many share brokers, firms, and commercial bank act as depository participants. We can see the depository or dematerialization process over here. Let's study that. You can have a look over here. Now let's study that. The first step is investor surrender certificate to DP, that is depository participant, for dematerialization. And DP informs the depository through electronic media. DP sends original certificate to registrar for verification or and cancellation. And depository sends formal request for dematerialization to registrar. Registrar informs depository of cancellation of certificates and electronic credit given to customers, and it also updates its account and information informs the DP concerned. Now this depository participant informs the customer about the credit in his account. So this was the procedure. The next one is National Stock Exchange, that is NSE. NSE was established in 92 at Mumbai, which was set up by LIC, GIC, Commercial Bank and other financial institution with paid up capital of rupees 25 crore. Now it has of course a nationwide coverage, which is having more than 6,000 trading terminals in 370 cities, and it provides you online trading. It also provides you transparency in dealing. That is, screen-based trading ensures complete transparency, and the computer itself another feature or objective of NSE is trading in dematerialized form. That is, trading is carried on dematerialized form and settlement of transactions are made on rolling settlement basis, that is T+2. So these are the features and objectives of NSE. And when we talk about the segments of NSE, it could be divided into wholesale, debt market or capital market segment. When we say wholesale debt market, debt instruments like government securities, treasury bills, PSUs and bonds are traded, and transactions are wholesale in nature and it involves high value. So individual brokers are not permitted over here. When we talk about capital market segment, it has retail market, shares and debentures of companies are traded, and listing is provided to companies having minimum paid up capital of 10 crores. So in order to get listed, you should be able to fill up or meet up with this condition of having minimum paid up capital of rupees 10 crores. And there are about 700 securities which are listed into this segment. Now let's talk about Bombay Stock Exchange, again, which is in Mumbai. Now, this was established in 1875. It is a voluntary non-profit association and oldest in Asia. First one recognized by the government. BSE is the only one that has been granted permanent registration. It has premier stock exchange, and companies having at least rupees 10 crores are eligible to be listed in BSE. And there are about 6,000 scrips listed. Securities are classified into many groups like A, B, T, and Z. Group A contains securities having good track record and large volume of business. Traditionally, trading was carried out on outcry system. And in 1995, it introduced a screen-based trading called BALT, that is BSE online trading. And at present, BALT has a nationwide network. Thank you very much.